In this video, I'm going to discuss the hydrodynamic stability of a Poiseuille flow using MATLAB. This is a well-known problem in fluid dynamics, and in the end, we are going to generate this neutral stability curve. So stay with me until the end. Let's specify the problem completely. We have a steady, incompressible, laminar, fully developed Poiseuille flow, which means there is a plane channel flow between two parallel plates. And we are going to perturb this flow with small amplitude disturbances in the form of traveling waves. Are these waves going to attenuate and die out? Or are they going to amplify and make the flow turbulent? First, we solve the steady laminar flow and ignore the disturbances. I write the incompressible form of Navier-Stokes equations. Since the flow is fully developed, we have no gradient in the x direction, and the continuity equation tells me that the y component of velocity, named v, has no gradient in the y direction. So the boundary conditions specify that v equals to 0. So v is equal to 0, temporal derivatives are 0, and gradients in the x direction are 0. This leaves us with only the x momentum equation, and if you integrate it twice with respect to y, and then apply no slip boundary conditions, you come up with this result for u. Here u is non-dimensionalized by centerline velocity, and y is non-dimensionalized by h. Now that we have the steady laminar solution, we can add the effect of our traveling waves in our domain. Since the waves have a small amplitudes, we can assume that the velocity components and pressure can be written as the sum of a base component and a small amplitude fluctuating disturbance component. Using imaginary numbers notation, these fluctuations can be written like this. Alpha is the wave number and it is a real positive value. C is the wave velocity and is a complex number, so it can be decomposed into a real and imaginary part. If you rewrite this expression, you can see that this is the fluctuating part and this is the temporal growth. So when is the flow going to be unstable? If the exponent of temporal growth is positive, the disturbances grow exponentially with time. Otherwise, they attenuate and the flow will remain stable. Back to our equations. If I put these equations in the Navier-Stokes equations and simplify them, I come up with these three equations. Instead of pressure, I can use kinematic pressure, which is pressure divided by density. And all of the derivatives are with respect to y, so I use prime notation. And our equations become simplified like this. If I eliminate p tilde and u tilde using these two equations, and non-dimensionalize the resulting equation by h and center line velocity, the result is going to be the fourth order linear Orr-Sommerfeld equation. Solving this equation determines the flow stability. We know this is u, and this is second derivative of u for Poiseuille flow. And these are the boundary conditions. Rewriting the Orr-Sommerfeld equation will show that since Reynolds number and alpha are known, this is an eigenvalue problem. So I take this coefficient to be lambda, and our aim is to find this complex eigenvalue. A very efficient and classic way to solve this equation is using spectral methods with Chebyshev differentiation matrices. I have a separate video about Chebyshev polynomials and how to use them for interpolating functions. So if you don't know what Chebyshev polynomials are, please consider watching that tutorial. These are some of the Chebyshev polynomials. Any non-periodic function over an interval of minus 1 and 1 can be written as a summation of Chebyshev polynomials. Don't worry about these coefficients. There are general equations to determine them. Again, if you are interested to see what are these coefficients, check out my other tutorial. The coefficients of this Chebyshev polynomial approximation can be written in a matrix form. You will see that this notation is going to help us with the derivative terms. The same way we have approximated our function with Chebyshev polynomials, we can also write its first derivative as a summation of Chebyshev polynomials. I don't want to go into details of deriving these matrices. You can check the references I mentioned in the video description. Just accept that there is a square n plus 1 times n plus 1 matrix called the Chebyshev differentiation matrix, which can help us deal with the derivative terms. And all of its elements are known through these equations. So the first derivative of v is d times v. The second derivative of v is d squared times v, etc. So until now, we have a linear fourth order equation. We considered v to be a summation of n Chebyshev polynomials. And the powerful features of these polynomials allow us to write any higher order derivative term in a matrix form. Rewriting the Orr-Sommerfeld equation in the matrix form will lead to this eigenvalue problem. And to solve it, I use MATLAB. First, I need a function to create Chebyshev nodes and this differentiation matrix. This is the general form of Chebyshev nodes. Then I define C. And having these four rules for differentiation matrix, I define D. In a new script, I define Reynolds number and alpha for our flow. I take n to be 50. I have checked that this value is enough for our problem. In other problems, you may need to increase the order of approximation. I recall my Chebyshev function, and having d, I define higher order derivatives. Now I type this equation. I is the identity matrix. And A and B are defined in a straightforward manner. To add homogeneous boundary conditions, I replace the first and last row of our matrices A and B with the corresponding homogeneous boundary conditions. And to add zero derivative boundary conditions, I replace the second row of A with the first row of D, and the nth row of A with the last row of D. Now I can easily calculate the eigenvalue lambda. And leaving out the first and last two rows of lambda, I have all of the eigenvalues. Remember that this is the fluctuating disturbances for V, and the temporal growth term determines the stability. So to check if any of the values for lambda are positive, I calculate the maximum value for the real part of lambda. If the response is positive, the flow is unstable, and if not, it is stable. You can see that for our specified Reynolds number and alpha, the flow is unstable. It is also common to plot the eigenvalues. To find out which values of Reynolds and alpha will lead to a stable or unstable flow, one way is to look at lambda for different values of Reynolds and alpha. So I make a function out of my code, and it returns the maximum value of lambda as its output. Now I define Reynolds and alpha in a region, for example 3000 to 70,000 for Reynolds number and 0.4 until 1.2 for alpha. To plot a 3D surface for lambda values, I should create a mesh using mesh grid function. If you want to know more about 3D plotting, check out my other tutorial right on top of this screen. Now I have my grid, and for every element I calculate lambda using my newly defined function. Also, to find the neutral stability curve, we should find the values in which maximum real part of lambda is 0. This is my way of doing so. For any given Reynolds number, I increase alpha, and whenever lambda changes its sign, I plot a star in the corresponding Reynolds number and alpha. You can always increase the grids in your domain to get more accuracy.